help me out here. So I know if I am in my socks and I'm 5 years old and I'm like running around the my carpeted living room, I'm going to generate static electricity. How do you generate static electricity when you're just rotor blades in the air?
You got a piece of plastic, blades of plastic, and you're running it through the air, and it's a bunch of molecules you run it into. You tend to see more on it. I'll give you the airplane example because I think it also applies here, which is we call it precipitation static a lot of times on aircraft. When aircraft gets charged, aircraft don't get charged all that much in clear air, and wind turbine blades also won't. So there's like really two kinds of charging that happen here. One is you're running into ice, frozen water. So there's a friction there. So as a blade hits these little ice particles, helicopter blade, airplane, wind turbine blade, it knocks off electrons, and then those electrons basically transfer from
and these
ice
are
molecules
how
to the blade.
Where are these particles and how big are they? They're in a cloud?
They tend to be small, in clouds, right? So it's not like hail in a sense, like as we sit on, it's in clouds. So if there's any clouds around the wind turbines, and a lot of these wind turbines are up at elevation, and they are in clouds, and there's if any of that precipitation is freezing or close to freezing, it can transfer charge from the water molecules over to the blade. So it's actually frictional charging, just like you rubbing your socks on the carpet. It's a friction charger because you're actually running into something that's hard. Rain doesn't do that as much. It can build up a little bit of a charge. But because water is pliable, when it's liquid state, it doesn't really transfer electrons from one thing to another.